Dak Prescott's numbers his last five games against the Giants. He certainly likes facing them. And he did something yesterday that Aikman and Romo never did. He finished a game with a perfect passer rating. Over 400 yards, four touchdowns. It seems like every time somebody doubts Dak, he rises to the occasion. We saw this offense at its full potential yesterday, Shrakes.
Yeah, you know, it's funny that Jerry came out and said that and Dak saying that. And Dak threw for 400 yards in this game. If there was any conflict between agent and team, or if there was any strife, I don't think they'd be saying, roll out the ball, keep on throwing. It's almost like it justifies the deal when they do give it to him. Mm-hmm. There is a lot of dancing in this and how these things get done, but I look at the offensive coordinator too, and Kellen Moore.
What a game.
And Dak Prescott had an incredible week one. If you're not aware of Kellen Moore, he's 31 years old. He was the Boise State quarterback. He was the quarterback's coach after being a backup quarterback in the league for a long time. They scored on five consecutive drives. Dak looked amazing, and he will get that new contract. He will make, and there won't be as many eyebrows raised as there were 2 weeks ago because look what he's already done. And that's how this works. Jerry and Todd France have been working almost together on this one to make it happen, and Dak bet on himself a little bit, saying, I'm going to show up in week one. I'm going to ball out, and you know what? It justifies the deal.
That was an incredible performance.
It was awesome.
It was a Rembrandt. I mean, that was an almost like a perfect game. It looked at one point like he was going to have three 100-yard receivers with Gallup and Amari. And I mean, that was unbelievable.
Bob.
And yet, if I'm Dak, like, I would not have come out at halftime without a new contract. Just stay in the locker room, go in the stall, pick up your feet so they don't see you. Because, guys, Daniel Jones made more money yesterday than Dak Prescott. And Alex Tanny, the third-string Giants quarterback, is in the same ballpark. So right now, after dropping one of the best games of my career, one of the biggest, there is a meme where there is a gentleman in, I guess it's a pimp suit, walking into a restaurant, and he just kind of walks in, and he's just like, here's Dak entering the negotiations right now. Like, Dak, go get paid. Go get all the money in the world. That was an incredible game.
Pay the man.
Hey, listen, let me pose a question.
Yes.
And not to the table. Let me get my camera. Where am I at? Let me talk to you. For everybody at home. So tell me again why Dak Prescott doesn't deserve to get $30+ million, 35 maybe. Go ahead. No, wait.
He's not elite.
I got all the time in the world. But you know who doesn't have all the time in the world? Jerry Jones. Because the longer you wait and the better that Dak Prescott plays, you're going to have to pay this man big. You're going to have to back up that Brinks truck and all of that money that you've been saving, those crumbs that's falling off that pot, you're going to have to give him everything. Mm. You know what? I hope Dak Prescott goes up there and holds you guys to every single red cent for making him wait. He's been a company dude. He showed up on time. He's done everything you want to do. And not to mention, he played the perfect game in a moment that was bigger than any other game for him in his career. He's going to break off the team as well as he should.
He's betting on himself, and he's one of those guys that's good at that. We know what he's done before, 14 game-winning drives. This performance, which was of personal importance to you, as you noted, remember when he took on Russell Wilson and the Seahawks last year? Like, he is good in these weird clutch, put-me-in-a-corner moments. So you're on notice, NFC. I know the Eagles looked good, but this is going to be
And those two are going to meet.
Division race.